Hello everyone, I'm Durgesh Sahani and we are creating series of video tutorials for CRUD operation on MongoDB in PHP by using MongoDB library. So in the previous session we have seen how to set up MongoDB on Windows machine. Now in this session we are going to see how to set up this MongoDB library, and they have recommended to download it through Composer. So here you can see on documentation we find this thing in install PHP library. So here they have given the preferred method of installing MongoDB PHP library is with Composer. So if you don't know about Composer, no problem, just click on this link and you'll go to the Composer. Just click on this get started, and for basic understanding why you need a Composer, so it called dependency manager for PHP. Okay, now suppose you have scenario, you have a project that depend on number of libraries and some of those libraries depend on the other libraries. Okay, so what Composer does for you is enable you declare the library you depend on, find out which version of which package can be needed to be installed and install them. Okay, so what we are doing generally is we are downloading that library and including it to our project and then setting the reference of that file. So no need to do those things, just all thing we can do it by using this Composer. So if you want to install it on Windows, just download this composer.setup.exe file which I already have downloaded at my machine. So here you can see, just double click on it once downloaded and just follow the steps. It's very simple. Next, no proxy setting. So here you can see PHP 7.2.1 it detected. Click on install. Okay, now open new command window. So if you have open any command windows, it will not affect until you close it and open it again. Okay, so just next and finish. So all the window you have opened, just close it. Now I'm going to open command prompt again, and here you can see if I enter Composer, here you can see Composer is successfully installed at my machine and I'm able to see some parameters which accept which Composer accept. Okay, so we have to install, and here you can see they have given just copy this thing, so it will download this MongoDB PHP library for you. Okay, so just go to the command prompt and go to the D drive actually, and then CD tutorials, then MongoDB, and here just run this. Okay, so what it will do, if you go to this directory, so I'll show you tutorials and then MongoDB. It have created this composer.json file, and it will download all the required file for us. So till the time it is downloading, let's understand this library. See, once it is downloaded, then what you can do, you have to just require it vendor. The Composer will download this vendor folder and one autoloader.php. So just you have to include this autoload.php file, and after that you will be able to access all the functions of this library. Okay, so if you go to these tutorials, you will find they have given the links how to work with this library. So CRUD operations, so the same thing we are going to follow. Okay, so they have given list of sections to articles, like you can go and read whatever you need. So if you want to insert one document to your MongoDB, here you can see we will see once it will download. Okay, so I think it is downloaded. Yeah, so if you go to this file folder, you can see this Composer file and then vendor, see, this is the autoload.php file which we need, and MongoDB. So here we have all these necessary things. See, client, collection, database. Okay, now just installation, and just copy this line and paste it over here. Okay, and if you remove this thing, then also no problem. Vendor, then autoload.php file, just remove these things, and I'll just copy the same tutorials which we were seeing. Insert one, we want to insert one data, okay, by using this library. So just copy this whole thing, and yes, here you can see I'm just going to drop this database. Okay, now okay, just delete this one, don't want it, we already have. Okay, so what it will try to do, it will create object of this client, and then it will try to create one test database and one table users, and we are calling this insert one function, and with these details. So just let me change it to, and everything will be same. So we'll see what is happening. So if you refresh this page, here you can see insert one document, and we got this. If you go here to what we have installed here is, and if you refresh it, actually system local, refresh it. So here you can see there is one more database created, test, and inside it you will find users. And if you click on this view document, you can see there is one record, and if you expand it, you can see here the same data what we have set it over here is this name and everything, it get saved to this database. Okay, and if you want to get this database, if you want to search it, so here same, you can get it from find one document, and you can call, see, this find one method. So just I'm just going to copy this, and over here just paste it. Okay, see, now I want to find for username, which name is this. Okay, so let's see whether we are getting it or not. If you refresh it, here you can see we are getting all this data. So you can see here data we are getting, string admin user, the same data which we have over here is. Okay, so this is a very simple example how you can use how you can download the composer, and how to download any library by using composer, and how to use it in your PHP file. Just you have to require it, and then you will be able to access all these things. Okay, so this is all about setting this library to your working directory. In the next session, we'll actually start our CRUD operations in MongoDB and PHP. Okay, so thank you very much guys for watching. If you like my videos, please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.